So you're a beginner, you're a sneakerhead, and you want to know where you can buy sneakers in bulk for retail. Now, I'm sure you see the Instagram plugs posting their entire living room full of shoe boxes, full of what was supposed to be a limited release, right? You wondering, number one, how is it possible? And number two, how you can make that possible. And so I'm gonna take you through it as somebody who is currently navigating this sneaker world, this sneaker market, and I'm gonna tell you exactly how you can do that. If you get to know me, if you subscribe to me, then you'll learn something about me. And all it is that I'm gonna give you every side of the story. And most importantly, I'm gonna tell you the truth so you can properly assess your options. Because the truth is, there's only two ways to buy sneakers in bulk for retail. And no, not buy in bulk the way you're thinking of it, all right? Because I'm gonna tell you right now, that is not possible. However, watch to the end of this video and I'm gonna give you two of the next best options. All right, so the first way is having a Nike VP as a mom. Nah, I'm just playing. The first way, truth be told, is the old fashioned way, all right? It's also the most practical, the most common, especially if you a hustler and a go-getter. And of course, that's all the stuff we've already talked about, right? Going to enter raffles, checking to see what's in stores, making trips, not knowing if it's gonna be a busted trip. A lot of people every day tell me like, bro, I'm not copping, I'm not able to cop, I'm not having no luck. And then I asked them if they've entered the raffle and if they've gone to a couple of stores and if they not only tried to go to a couple of different stores or did they try to cop manually online on a bunch of different stores. And the answer is always, nah, bro, I just tried the sneakers out. And I'm gonna be 100% honest with you, that's simply not enough. You have to exhaust every option you have available to you, all right? And here's a little known fact that I thought was common knowledge, but not everybody knows. You do know that sneakers drop in other places other than the sneakers app, all right? So there's a lot of online retailers that drop hype releases. And not only do they release hype releases, they have their own raffles as well. So you need to be entering every single one of those. Now here's the truth, 70% of the sneaker plugs you see on Instagram, they built their empire all off of footwork, bro. One of the biggest sneaker pages in my region, the Dallas-Fort Worth area, DC Souls, they're just two young guys. And yes, they plugged in now, but when they started, it was just all footwork, exhausting their options, going from different stores, just doing everything they can to get the shoes together. And when you hit a couple of raffles and then you're able to get first come, first serve here at a store, then those pairs add up and then boom, here you are with 10 pairs on release day. There's resellers out there that are hitting 20 and 30 pairs off the Flex app, bro. And guess what? That app, that method is available to all of us. And briefly, the way that works is through Foot Locker, you get points for buying shoes. And the more points you have, the better chances you have of copping future hype releases. So that's a win-win. It's just a snowball, bro, and it gets bigger and bigger. Raffles, places like the FLX app that I just mentioned, all those places give you a better chance of copping multiple pairs. And no, you won't hit on them every single time. I'm not telling you that by any stretch. For each release, you should be entering on every single raffle there is on the internet, every single reservation drawing on the internet. I mean, there's just several ways to do it. And like I said, the footwork, going to checking out stores, going and seeing who has stock where. So this is the most common way to buy in bulk. And like I said, it's not how you would think of buying them all in one chunk. However, this is the next best way to buy wholesale, to buy bulk sneakers for retail. Stay tuned because number two is coming right up. All right, so the next way, I'm sorry, it's the dreaded B word. Now I told you I was gonna be honest with you, right? Botting is the second and only other way to actually buy sneakers for retail in bulk. Now the world of botting has got super popular over the last few months. It's something that's sort of always been taking place in the underground. So basically the idea of botting is using software to check out multiple pairs on any website. Now these bots are 10 times faster than humans and can send multiple queries, once again helping you get multiple pairs of shoes. You tried to buy a PS5 or anything honestly online with any hype over the last year and it sold out within 30 seconds, those were because of bots. Now botting has taken the blame as far as the demise and the end of the good old days of the sneaker world. And while I do understand that sentiment, I just wanna be honest and say, as someone who is a sneakerhead myself, I was hit with a get with it or get ran over moment when I consider botting myself. To be 100% candid, I got tired of not copping and not having a chance to cop. So I say, you know what? You can't beat them, join them. Now, if you look around, even on YouTube, you will see that, man, some of the biggest botters sometimes check out 50 to 100 pairs on a hype release. That's the other 30% of resellers that I'm talking about. And honestly, that's good news for you, especially if you're interested in getting into botting, because that means there's still room for new people to get in. Now, like I said, I'm gonna always give you the good, bad, and ugly. Botting is mostly ugly, and it's honestly not as easy as it sounds. It doesn't guarantee you anything. However, if you can master it, you can get sneakers in bulk at retail, and not only that, but you can really, really maximize your profits. Right now, getting into botting is as easy as it's ever been. Realistically, you need about $800 to $1,000 to start botting. A good entry-level bot is gonna cost you around $500, and then you need to buy things that make the bot work, like proxies. And just to shortly explain what proxies are basically IP addresses that allow you to spoof your IP address so that you can cop multiple pairs. Now, here's a disclaimer about botting, and I tell everybody this. Out of every 10 people that start botting, 7 to 8 is gonna be nothing but a money pit, and they're gonna fall. And they're gonna eventually not wanna bot anymore. For you to stick out and be one of those 2 to 3 people who do become a successful botter, it's simple. You just gotta pay attention, learn as much as you can, try different things, and honestly just understand what you signed up for. Always strive to improve, and if you can do that, I'm confident you can become a botter. It's easier than it sounds, and there's a lot of learning resources here on YouTube if you want to do that. Honestly, I'm still striving to become one of those myself. Buying sneakers in bulk for retail is possible, but not in the way that everybody would imagine. I have a series about using sneaker reselling, and I'm going all manual to turn $100 to $1,000. So meet me over at that video. Love everybody out there. Let's get it.